Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy with Van On Company. It's Thursday, July 21st. I'm going to go over the markets with you for the day. Really mixed trade throughout the day as you struggled to find a direction to go into. No new news as far as that weather fronts really go. I mean, you have updated those models and they are looking favorable for crop production, which is bearish towards prices. But for the most part, it's still extended, so this market's not really taking them quite yet. But your 6 to 10 looks good. Your 8 to 14 day looks really good. So calling for normal temperatures, above normal precip for majority of the Corn Belt, especially Nebraska, which got hit with the hardest with the heat, and through South Dakota as well, which will be a welcomed relief there. So you're looking at some good weather forecast here. You also got extended forecast updated from NOAA, which came in here and did average chance for both below or above normal precip or normal temperatures for August, and then chance for higher amounts of precip for August for majority of the Corn Belt as well. So you're coming in here with some forecasts that look favorable for crop conditions. Because of that, you found some pressure to push us back to those lows we saw 2 weeks ago into the corn market. Beans kind of just took a breather from the selling pressure and actually came up about 9 cents a couple times throughout the day, but would continue to find selling pressure, closed up 6 cents on the day. And then wheat actually closed slightly higher with a favorable US dollar coming back and retracting a little bit from those recent highs. So you saw wheat actually close up about a penny to 3 or 4 cents there. So nothing too major into the grain markets. Actually very quiet day as far as watching those trades. Meat markets, a little bit of a different situation, much lower trade there as you do have some liquidation occurring, some unfavorable cash talks. So you actually had live cattle down 250 to 275, almost limit lower. Same situation in a feeder cattle, almost limit lower, trading about $4 lower there. And then into the lean hogs, actually about a buck or two lower as well. So that pressure came through throughout there. Like I said, the dollar, the US dollar, much weaker, down about 25 cents. It started off slightly higher like crude and the Dow did, but throughout the day actually faded with crude being down about a buck. And then, like I said, dollar down 25, and then the Dow was down over 100 points there. So overall, some negativity into these markets. You're going to be waiting to see how these weather models actually pan out. We get through the heat and to see if those still stay favorable towards crop conditions. You know, there's a lot of wiggle room, not a lot of wiggle room into this bean market as far as poor yield versus good yield on those carryout levels. It takes it from a very tight carryout to a very ample carryout. So any weather news you're going to get as far as those beans go is really going to push these markets in one way or another. It's very sensitive to weather as far as right now, but the more you push it, the more you start to have people say that the corn crop is starting to be made and there's not going to be many issues or a chance to get some issues out of those as well. You start talking that really the only price movement you're going to see into corn now would be coming off a freeze scare. But that's moving forward. That's a ways out there as well. So I do have to close with a disclaimer. Trading futures and options involves risk of loss. It may not be suitable for all producers. Have a great day.